إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم شهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. All praises is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and seek His aid and ask for His forgiveness. And we seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evils of ourselves and our evil actions. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, there is none who can misguide Him. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, there is none who can guide Him. And I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, having no partner. And I bear witness that Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, is his slave and his messenger. I recite a verse 185, chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah of the Holy Quran. The Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, you shall complete the number of days and you may be glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his guiding you and that you may be grateful. This verse of Quran refers to the completion of 29 or 30 days of fasting in the Islamic month of Ramadan and the celebratory day, we call it the Eid al-Fitr. This Eid al-Fitr is literally means the festival of breaking the fast. Muslims celebrate Eid depending on the sighting of the new moon. This celebration and being thankful is not due to the month of fasting coming to an end, but rather Muslims have had the great opportunity to take part in the month of forgiveness and to seek spiritual awakening and enlightenment. The month of Ramadan gives believers the opportunity to perfect one's inner self and character, like patience, generosity, kind and feeding or assisting others have been tested and tried in the holy month of Ramadan. I pass it gratitude but be shown to the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ability to be guided towards the personal growth. Therefore, in the month of Ramadan, the emphasis of the completing good deeds while observing fasts is rewarded even more in this month than the any other month of the year. In Islam, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala special month. During this period, the Holy Quran were revealed. When it has ended, if Muslims bettered themselves by not, for instance, speaking ill of others, lying or not controlled one's anger while abstaining from food and drink, then they have succeeded and it is a celebration. Whenever pity is attained, it is a reason to rejoice. I remember a hadith of Abu Dawood, hadith number 1134. An Anas qala qadima Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Madina. ولهم يومان يلعبون فيهما فقال ما هذان اليومان قالوا كنا نلعب فيهما في الجاهلية فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله قد أبدلكم بهما خيرا منهما يوم الأضحى واليوم الفطر. Anas ibn Malik narrated that when the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, came to Medina, they had 2 days when they would play. He said, what are these 2 days? He said, we used to play on these 2 days during the Jahiliyyah. The Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you in a state of 2 days that are better than them. That is Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. This hadith indicates that Eid al-Fitr is not something which Muslims have fabricated or created on their own. Neither it's created in commemoration or remembrance of someone. Rather, it is a festival that is a special gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Muslim Ummah. I remember a quote from Ali ibn Abu Talib. He was the first Imam or successor after the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. He stated, "Eid is for just or Eid is for them whose fasts have been accepted by the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and whose worship has been appreciated by the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every day in which you do not disobey the Creator is a day of Eid. Eid is a festive occasion where the Muslims wear their finest and go to the mosque for congregational Eid ul prayer in the morning. The believer also must give charity to the poor on behalf of themselves and of every family member. Muslims on Eid also exchange their greetings, gifts and visit friends and family and continue to pass the day of joyful. Eid is truly a time to unify in the community. Eid is surely a new day and a new beginning for a person who has just completed a month of fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you are grateful, I will increase you. What He will increase? He will increase the safety by this ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase the guidance, increase our faith, increase the rizq, increase the health and more. He will increase all these things if we just become grateful. So let's come out of this Ramadan reminding ourselves what it means to be grateful. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lilwali alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lilwali alhamd. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر وللبال الحمد الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباد الله الذين اصطفى خصوصا على أفضلهم خاتم النبي محمد الأليم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين يقول الأوزوجك في كتابه الكريم بعد أن قل أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا يصلون على الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. My parting words to all of you as part of being grateful. Be grateful for the people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in your life. The family members that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in your life. Your friends, your relatives. If you have been in a fight, you have been in an argument, you haven't been talking to your beloved ones. If something has happened, drop it all and let it go. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be greater to connect with them. If you forgive anyone, Allah will forgive you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and your family. Congratulations to all. Eid Mubarak.